Very good.
Miss Peretti, please spell syzygy.
Syzygy. S-Y-Z-Y-G-Y. Syzygy?
We have a winner!
Thank you!
At the 25th annual Putnam County Spelling Bee, my parents keep on telling me, just being here is winning, although I know it isn't so.
But it's a very nice, very, very nice, very, very nice, very nice beginning. Our winner here last year, Chip Tolentino.
Great!
And our youngest competitor, Miss Logan Schwartz and Grumineer. I'm not sure who this girl is. Marcy Park, winner's destination. Washington, D.C.
Glad brought to me in a fancy hotel where they treat you well. All because you love to sell.
Annual Putnam County
like to take this moment to ask you to please turn off all cell phones and other distracting devices. Oh, and please turn off your cameras. Sorry, no photos at the bee. Now, it seems that I'm still missing a few spellers, so if I call your name, please come up either side and join the other spellers at their seats. I'm missing a Mr. Nick Endo. Mr. Abdi Abakar, and Genevieve Carone. Ladies and gentlemen, the children you see before you are here because of their extraordinary ability and their love of language. But only one of them can go on to compete in the National Spelling Bee. This year, to celebrate our silver anniversary, our local sponsors, the Putnam Optometrists, will be providing today's winner with a $200 savings bond towards his or her future education. That's about $200. But if a child had to win, or place, in his or her own District B, so each of them is already a winner.
Already a winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Rona Lisa Peretti, and I am so happy to be back for my 9th consecutive year as your host. Unfortunately, our usual word pronouncer, Father McShane, is stuck waiting for the Kian elevator in Death. Welcoming Vice Principal Douglas Ponch from Lake Hemingway Dos Passos University. Which is returned to us after a 5-year hiatus. So thank you, Douglas, for joining us on such short notice.
Thank you, Rona. As to that incident 5 years ago, I'd like to say that I'm in a much better place now. It's amazing what a change in diet can do for a man. Thank you.
Wonderful.
And may I also add that Miss Peretti here is not only one of Putnam County's top realtors, she is also a former spelling champion herself.
Third annual.
Syzygy.
Syzygy, when the earth aligns with the moon and the sun.
Oh. And now for our Pledge of Allegiance, led by our very own comfort counselor, Mr. Mitchell M. Mahoney.
Mr. Mahoney is here doing his community service work with us today.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands under God,
liberty and justice. Spellers, be seated. Thank you, Mitch.
And now for the official Spelling Bee rules.
A speller.
A speller.
May ask questions. About the words, pronunciation, or definition.
Definition.
Use in a sentence.
In a sentence.
And language of origin.
Language of origin.
If you start to spell a word, you may start over.
But the sequence of letters already so may not be changed.
Catastrophe. I love what I see. Kids acting innocently.
Schwartz and Grubinier.
Miss Schwartz and Grubinier is head of the Gay Straight Alliance at her elementary school.
Strabismus.
Strabismus. May I please have a definition of that word?
The inability of one eye to obtain binocular vision with the other because of an imbalance in the muscles of the eyeball.
And use in a sentence, please?
Billy explained to his peers out on the playground that it was ableist to say that he suffers from strabismus and that he prefers to say he lives with an ocular disorder.
Okay, now notice how she writes on her forearm. This is her way of visualizing the word before speaking it out loud.
Strabismus. S-T-R-A-B-I-S-M-U-S. Strabismus.
That is correct. Mr. Coney Bear.
Mr. Coney Bear was second runner-up at the Putnam Basin District.
Brooke, will you tell Leaf he has a phone call?
Leaf, phone.
Thanks, I got it. Hello, Leaf speaking. Oh, you're kidding. You want me to represent the basin in the beat? Well, I just can't believe it. Mom, Dad, Marigold, Brooke, a raisin, pinecone, landscape, Paul. You're not gonna believe this.
What's up, Leaf?
I made the county finals for the spelling bee.
Sweetheart, no, you came in third, honey.
I know, but they just called to tell me that the person who came in first has to go to their bat mitzvah, and the person that came in second has to attend the bat mitzvah, so now they're on me to do it!
You understand all the other children will have won their district fees?
Capybara.
What?
Your word is capybara.
No.
Is that a real word?
That's a word, yes.
What does it mean?
It's a tailless, largely aquatic South American rodent, often exceeding 4 feet in length.
Awesome! What else can I ask?
You're allowed to ask for the word's language of origin or to have it used in a sentence.
Oh, well, then can you use it in a sentence?
Certainly. Don't look now, Pedro, but I think that tailless, largely aquatic, 4.5-foot rodent swimming next to you may be a capybara. Spell the word, Mr. Coney Bear.
No, but it was fun coming here. Hi, guys. My whole family's here, which is really C-A-P-Y-B-A-R-A, capybara.
That is correct.
It is? I can't believe it. Woo! I just said the first couple words that came into my head, and that why was really...
Shh! Mrs. Strauss.
Miss Ostrovsky came in second in her school's Halloween contest.
I was roadkill.
Boanthropy.
Boanthropy? Can I have a definition?
The delusion that one has become an ox.
Excuse me, sir? Sir, can you not sit in that seat? I saved a chair for my dad in the eighth of Nietzsche's.
are the friends that I'll have forever, more than the friends I have made in school.
Lugubrious.
correct.
I know.
Mr. Ibacar.
Mr. Ibacar is adamantly pro-pickle.
Backpack.
Backpack. Come on, that's so easy!
Only the spell at the microphone may repeat the word.
Fair. Can I get the definition of the word?
Dora the Explorer's sexually ambiguous yet ever-present purple sack cat.
Like a good girl, Dora always asks Backpack for consent before putting anything inside.
Delicioso!
Backpack. B-A-C-K-P-A-C-T.
I'm sorry, what was the last one?
B-A-C-K-P-A-C-T.
I'm sorry. That is incorrect.
What is this idiot?
Backpack is B-A-C-K-P-A-C-K.
Containing religious texts traditionally worn on the left arm and head by Jewish men during morning weekday prayers.
Thank you. May I have a sentence, please?
Conrad, put down that phylactery. We're Episcopalian.
Phylactery. P-H-Y-L-A-C-T-E-R-Y. Phylactery?
That is correct.
Slam dunk from Park.
Hey, Marcy, you were at Nationals. Do you remember me?
I only remember the top 10.
Mr. Tolentino.
Charlito Chip Tolentino is a little league pitcher with a wicked 22 mile an hour screwball.
That's not very fast. I'm fellow Skepsis.
Wait, didn't that other kid just get Backpack?
Yes, and you got fellow Skepsis.
But are those even rated at the same level of difficulty?
They're both rated level one words, yes.
You're shitting me!
Throw profanity at the beat!
Omphaloskepsis.
Can it also be pronounced omphaloskepsis?
It can. It would be wrong.
Omphaloskepsis. O-M-P-H-A-L-O-S-K. E-P-S-I-S, omphaloskepsis.
That is correct.
He rallies and he nails it. That's what it means to be a true champion.
Miss Caron.
Miss Caron likes dogs more than people.
Yes. Cow.
Come on!
Are you kidding? Only spell her at the microphone may repeat the word.
Can I have the definition, please?
Yes. It means cow.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Please spell cow.
Cow. C-O-W.
That is correct.
My, oh my.
super salad. Spell
gerbil.
Smart. Or school at home, they see who's bright, it breaks my heart.
swatting.
Dumb kid!
Everyone keeps yelling.
Dumb kid!
How can a flea such as me think he'd be good at spelling?
I don't know. I like my hair. Really, it is pleasant to the touch. I toss my hair a bit too much. It doesn't move. It simply sits. I make a point. I'm not that smart.
Yeah.
Mr. Barfi.
It's pronounced parfait.
Mr. Barfi made it to finals last year, but had to be eliminated for health-related reasons.
Did someone put the peanuts in the brownies? Because they said there wouldn't be no peanuts in the brownies!
I'm so happy to see him back and spelling so well.
Hassan Pepper.
Oh, yes, of course, Hassan Pepper, a highly seasoned rabbit stew often served with sour cream.
Rabbit stew? Yes, that's correct.
My friend, one moment, please.
He's going for the fight.
Magic foot, take me to the final round. Magic foot, barely lifted off the ground. Magic foot, I do without making a sound. Magic foot, write the letter. Magic foot, write the perfect letter. Magic foot, it's the alphabet or way to spell. Okay, let's see what we got here, foot. H-A-S-E-N. Hassan. P-F-E-F-F. P-F-F. E-R. Let's go. Magic foot. Be specific, magic foot. It's horrific if you're not specific, magic foot. It's terrific when you make a word. Magic foot,
magic foot, magic foot, magic foot, magic foot,
magic foot.
Don't go kaput, foot,
magic foot.
Write the goddamn letter.
Magic foot,
do what you want.
It's the alphabet or way to stop.
Do 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 do.
Teaching and practice of wrestling.
Can you use it in a sentence?
What happens in the palaestra stays in the palaestra.
Palaestra. P-A-L-E-S-T-R-A. Palaestra.
I'm sorry. Correct spelling is P-L-A... P-A-L-A-E-S-T-R-A.
Becoming the youngest high school freshman in parochial school history.
Quimacum.
Quimacum, a lieutenant or deputy of the Ottoman Empire, a rare exception to the QU rule from the Turkish, Q-A-I-M-A-Q-A-M.
That's remarkable.
And correct.
This park is all business.
I am not.
Mr. Tolentino.
Marigold. Marigold, Coney Bear.
Mr. Tolentino.
Jean Chip. Marigold.
Chip!
I'm sorry, is it my turn to spell?
A rare break in concentration for Mr. Tolentino.
Could you maybe skip me now and ask me to do it later?
Why on earth would you want me to do that?
I'd rather not say.
Mr. Tolentino, you either take your turn now or forfeit.
I'll take my turn now.
Another excellent decision by the incumbent.
Tint up.
What?
Tit up! Tit up!
Can I have the definition?
It means lively movement or behavior, or to move restlessly. It refers to the sound of a horse's hooves. Tit up. Tit up. Tit up.
Tit up. T I. T, U, oh, wait, two T's, you heard both, right? Going back, T, I, T, T, U, P, tit up.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is T, I, T, T, U, P.
Oh, but that's exactly what I said.
But first you said T, I, T, U, oh wait, you heard the first two T's, right?
I was just making sure you heard. I obviously know how to spell it.
If you start to spell a word, you may start over.
But see, there's a letter already, so we may not be
sure. That's not fair. I spelled it right. I can't get out of the word that I spelled it right.
Friends, I'm in the fair. Life is pandemonium.
This isn't fair. I won last year.
That's the reason they despair.
Life is pandemonium. Life is pandemonium. Life is pandemonium. Life is pandemonium.
You can't comfort these damn kids. They don't yet know that the good don't always win. So there's nothing you can say to cheer them up when they lose. I want to tell them the disappointment doesn't last.
But from what I've seen,
disappointment lasts like hell. I want to tell them that words don't matter, but from what I've seen, words can get you killed. I just want to beat them up a little. So they know that pain has degrees, and this is nothing. This is nothing, you little prick! But that would violate my parole. So, I do what I can. I give them a hug and a juice box. I'm here to give comfort. Let's go, kid.
Miss Brady, can I have one more chance? Please.
Thank you.
his spirit condiment is garlic salt.
Caterjunes.
Can I have a definition, please?
That definition is actually unknown. It exists in the oral tradition. Seems to be an old Nantucket whaling term.
Can you please use it in a sentence?
There is one written citation. There's a note about a Scotch-Irish accent. It's fine. The night tide is upon us. The Leviathan nears. Caterjunes.
Caterjunes. C-A-T-T-E-R-J-U-N-E-S. Caterjunes.
That's correct. Mr. Endo?
Mr. Endo's favorite color is clear.
Agdesiast.
May I have the definition, please?
A striptease artist.
Could you use it in a sentence?
Politically correct Tom told his daughter Leslie, use agdesiast. Not stripper, that's insulting.
Ecdesiast. E-C-K-D-E-S-I-A-S-T. Ecdesiast.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is E-C-D-Y-S-I-A-S-T.
My friend, you will be missed. But now go with dignity. This ends the first on our list. You should go with pride. You've been the best looking dude we've had all day. You're a real smart dude as well. Now go home and spell. Give your squeeze some affection. Come on, make a connection.
Screw it! Who wants free candy? that everything I did perfectly. Last year's chip defeated because of Miracle Tony Bear. Because there's something and not a thing between us. I don't blame my brain, but I do blame my penis. My unfortunate protuberance seems to have its own exuberance and your own first-hand events. Delicious and appropriate. Anyone for chippy goobers. Expensive. Anyone for buying the shit that I'm selling. Because my stiffy has ruined my spelling.
Country Day, Mr. William Barfy.
From Garrison Elementary, Miss Olive Ostrovsky.
Miss Pretty, my dad.
And from the Magma Magna Grammar School, Miss Logan Schwartz and Grubinier.
I'd like to take this moment to thank my two fathers, Daniel Schwartz and Carl Grubinier, who've been so supportive of me in all my endeavors. Thank you, Dad.
We hate losers, which is why we discipline. God hates losers. Because losers do not know how to win.
Barfay!
correct ending was I-L-L-A. Chinchilla.
I hear the bell. That, my friend, is not an inviting sound. That little ding. To me, it brings a plaintive air. I always thought that life was fair. But still, I never felt a smidgen of despair. They say a bell can break your heart, but just not mine. Since I opine, I think no. I know I'm smart. Apple juice, please.
Sheila says my hobbies are weird, but my real mom, Joan, says that the science will pay off one day, and also that I will grow up to be incredibly handsome.
Antihistamine.
Look at the draw. One moment, please. A-N-T-I-H-I-S-T-A-M-I-N-E. Antihistamine, Doug Panshi.
Doug Patch.
William Barfay.
Miss Park.
Miss Park speaks 5 languages.
No, I don't.
Don't you?
No.
Well, it also says that you won your school's handwriting competition.
And does it also say that I only get 3 hours of sleep each night? And that I hide in the bathroom cabinet? And that I'm not allowed to cry?
No.
Should, and it should say, I speak 6 languages.
6.
Every language easy. Easy as the recipe for making jello. I speak 6 languages. And I can say hello. In at least 7 more. To excel in athletics is not difficult if one has a temperament. Apparently, I have the temperament. Yes, I
is camouflage.
Camouflage? Dear Jesus, can't you come up with a harder word than that?
Of course I can, my child.
Marcy?
Hi!
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine. Is that your prayer, Marcy, for a more difficult word?
Oh, well, it was, but now that you're here, can I ask for something better?
I'm here for you now, Marcy. C'est pour toi que je suis ici.
Jesus, I was wondering what would happen if I didn't win today.
What do you think would happen?
I don't know. But what I mean is, would you be disappointed in me if I lost?
Of course not. But I also wouldn't be disappointed with you if you won.
Sir, same as up to me then.
Yes, and I'm also saying this isn't the kind of thing that I care very much about.
Camouflage. CAMOUFLAGE. Camouflage.
That's fucking wrong!
Your parents are in India.
No, only my mom is.
My dad is coming from work.
My apologies for that incident, everyone. Thank you, Mitch, for the tough love. Juice box. In my defense, I only had a salad at lunch. Anyway, Miss Ostrowski.
Miss Peretti, what did my dad say?
Oh, he said that he's running late and he'll discuss the entrance fee after work.
But did he say what time he's going to get here?
Chimerical.
Can I have a definition?
It means unreal, imaginary, visionary, wildly fanciful, highly unrealistic.
I wish you were home.
wildly fanciful.
That's correct.
Sentence, please.
She thought that she was walking into the dawn, but it turns out it was the crepuscule.
Ew. Crepuscule. C-R-E-P-U. S-C-U-L-E, crepuscule.
That is correct.
What? Mom! I did it without the foot!
Miss Schwartz and Rubinier.
I'd just like to say, Carl Dad, I can do this on my own.
Bug.
Bug? That the whole word, bug?
Bug.
Language of origin?
Cornish dialect, a Latin derivative.
Cornish, that's like English with Dutch influence. Bug. V-U-G-G-H-E, Vug.
Sorry, the correct spelling is V-U-G.
So simple?
So simple.
I'm so sorry, Dad. I overcomplicated. I hope you still love me, America. America, I gave it my best try. If you still don't love me, America, I understand why you hate losers. So do I. I'm a loser. So goodbye.
Triumphantly, in this moment of habit, season three, it's my favorite. word that can be turned upside down, but it's still the same word.
Fabacia.
Fabacia, and does that happen to be the longest word that can be played on a musical instrument?
Chromatophore.
Oh, chromatophore. And if you were to rearrange the letters of that word, would you be able to make the phrase Mr. Poop Ain't It Wrong?
Or Cheap Food Mister?
Pop Home Carrot?
Rap Home Popcorn?
Mr. Harvey, please spell Astral Plane.
To think that I might win it is astounding news, and I'm about to burst. How wonderful it feels to stand so close to first.
B-L-B.
I'll make it happen, and not as previously.
Correct, Mrs. Strovsky. Alien guesses.
Am I a Red Sox or a Yankee? Who will come in second? People are scared of me and no one really likes me. I won't come in second. Hey, Olive, don't think I'm distracted by your eyes and your smile and your hairdo. All the things I do not dare to. My fears are odious and fecund. You will not outrank me, I will wave my hanky. Second, I won't come in second.
Second.
I won't come in second.
Second.
Spelling is E-L-A-N-G-U-E-S-C-E-N-C-E.
Now remember, no speller can win on another speller's mistake. Mr. Barthes needs to get the next word correct in order to take the B.
Are you ready, William?
Yes, thank you, Doug. I'm ready.
And please spell Weltanschauung.
Oh. Weltanschauung, of course. Meaning one's personal perspective, the way they look at the world, their philosophy.
That is correct.
I know. A W E L T A N S C H A U U.
Condescend.
My fears are odious and they're not.
I am
enjoying.
UNG, Felton Shang.
We have a winner!
So hard for this moment. All my life, I've only been able to breathe through one nostril. And today is no exception.
And in addition, this year our sponsors are also offering a runner-up prize.
They are?
Yes, yes, of course. In the case that the winner cannot fulfill his or her responsibilities as Putnam County spelling champ, then the runner-up must step in and assume all spelling responsibilities. And so this year our sponsors are also offering a cash prize of $25 to the second place finisher. Nice going, Ms. Ostrowski.
Thank you. I can't believe it, thank you. Oh, Ms. Ostrowski, Ms. Peretti, I can't hit it. I can't say no. Very good. Very good.
Very good.
Well, good B.
Oh, thanks, you too, Ostrowski.
That stupid mistake on Ilan Gessens.
Oh, no. I didn't know that word either.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I totally knew how to spell that word.
Hey, Bart, congratulations.
Oh, of course.
Oh, Bart, I didn't know how to
spell that word. Yeah, come on.
Doug Pench found a new passion in life. Her name was Rona Lisa Fred. After recording her tirelessly for over 2 years, she finally took out a restraining order against him. Still, he was grateful for the opportunity to experience love.
Left Putnam County for a stretch and traveled the world to bring competitive spelling to the less fortunate. She hosted bees in Latvia, Sweden, and the Republic of Guinea-Bissau, where she fell in love with an indigenous cashew farmer and went on to become the top realtor in that country.
Ed Mahoney discovered a new talent at the Putnam Bee, so he decided to make his community service lifelong. Comforting frustrated educators and eliminated spellers, he kept in touch with scores of the people that he touched.
Tolentino made it through his adolescence and, over the course of time, came to appreciate his erection. As did many others.
She later wrote a book titled Not Living Up to Expectations. It did not live up to expectations. She is very happy.
Here has cats.
Her speech therapy was completely successful.
away, study for finals with his new friend, Olive Ostrovsky. He came in 42nd, top 50. In later years, he grew up to be incredibly handsome. And to gain fame and notoriety for his combined studies in the combined fields of psychiatry and podiatry, otherwise known as post-chiatry.
Olive Ostrovsky went home to an empty house, an uncertain future, and a well-worn dictionary. But with a strange new conviction that she could face all three. She grew up to be an attentive parent and host of her own radio talk show, where every year she interviewed the runner-up of the Putnam County Spelling Bee.
Number one, our director, Krista Feblis. Our stage manager, Anastasia Caron. And the love of our life, Mr. Piano Dan Wilson.